rose-colored glasses are off, it's time to get real. Yet, we remain hopeful still. This is the Marketing Disenchanted Podcast. I am your host, Temitayo Osinubi. Let's get to it. Welcome to episode 4 of the Marketing Disenchanted Podcast. This week, I am joined by none other than my co-author, my partner in crime, Michelle A. Bassett. Michelle holds an undergraduate in behavior analysis from Savannah State University and a master's degree in internet marketing from Full Sail University, where we met and one short year later published our book, Beyond Buzzwords, which you can get at thinkbeyondbuzzwords.com as well as Amazon. And please do leave a review. So without further ado, let's get into this one-of-a-kind interview with Michelle A. Bassett. Thanks so much for joining me. I have the distinct pleasure of speaking to none other than Miss Michelle A. Bassett. Full disclosure, she is my co-author for our book, Beyond Buzzwords, Social Media, Mobile, and Other Marketing Buzzwords Ain't the Half of It. She also holds a master's degree in internet marketing from Full Sail University, and is all around just a very knowledgeable, intelligent young professional. So, Michelle, thanks so much for taking the time.
Nice to be here as well.
Absolutely. So the road to digital marketing tends to be a winding one. So tell us that story. When did you first get bit by the bug, and how did you become enchanted with digital marketing?
Well, first, let me start with how I got into entrepreneurship. I got into entrepreneurship via a company that rhymes with Spamway. I'm not going to mention any names here, but they showed me the path of living a lifestyle that I didn't have access to before. They pretty much packaged up a dream and sold it to me, and I ate every bit of it. The problem was was that I was at my second junior year at Savannah State University, and I was already deeply into the behavior analysis program. So I kind of went for it a little bit, but you know, if you've ever been in a network marketing or MLM company, it's really, really hard to do what they sell you as a dream, because you need to get like 5 people under you, and then you need the 5 people under you, and when you're dealing with a bunch of broke college kids that don't care about nothing but, you know, spending their refund check on the latest and hottest whatever, then it gets kind of hard to have the money to fund that MLM dream, right. So I'm in college, I'm doing something that rhymes with Spamway. And then I head online. Someone got me with a very similar model. I was already indoctrinated with the you get one that gets two that gets one type network marketing model. And I got involved in this company called, I can't think of anything that rhymes with this, but it was Infinity Downline. It was a money gifting program. which, by the way, if you've never heard of that, that is completely and totally illegal and should not do this. But it was a money gifting program, essentially.
Okay.
And from Infinity Downline, I learned that you don't necessarily have to talk to people, because believe it or not, people don't believe this. You don't believe this, because I tell it to you all the time. Like, I'm shy. I'm genuinely a shy person. I'm not that person that'll like just walk up to people and be like, "Hey, I'm Michelle. Come talk to me about this Ponzi scheme. I'm gonna set you up and I'm gonna sell you some gold nuggets." And so I'm usually not that person. Over the past couple of weeks, I've been more of that person because I'm bored and I like to cause chaos in people's lives. But that's a different story for a different day. So I saw the digital marketing light, the beacon of hope, through a network marketing company called Infinity Downline.
Absolutely. So what happened after that? When was the honeymoon over? When did you become disenchanted? Not necessarily disillusioned, but when did that sort of shiny veneer come off and you were like, okay, stuff just got real?
Well, that was during my the end of my second junior year at Savannah State University, towards the beginning of my first and only senior year at Savannah State University. So after your first and only senior year at Savannah State or any college that you're in, you are eventually going to graduate, or you're going to run out of money, and then you're going to be homeless and everything gets sad after that. So, you graduate. Yay, you did it. Hooray. 6 months after that, there's a little person that exists in the world called Sally Mae. Again, I don't know who this person actually is, but Sally Mae calls you relentlessly. And the only way to get out of that is to either find her money, which at the time she wanted like $40,000. I don't know what 22-year-old you know to get $40,000 laying around. I'm pretty sure they exist. But I needed about $40,000, $50,000. And I didn't have it. So that was option one, come up with her money. Option two, go back to school. And hell, I made it that far. So I decided to go back to school. This time I went to school for internet marketing. And you would think after that life would be, you know, roses and sunshiny petals. But then during the program, I wound up doing penny clicks, which is exactly what it sounds like. Clicking for pennies, which is the real world equivalent of getting prospects at truck stops. And that is the end of that story that I'm going to say on this particular podcast. But it is definitely not dignifying at all. There's no dignity in that. Just clicking for pennies. I know better, do better. But my disenchantment of digital marketing is actually still continuing. The more I'm in it professionally, the more disenchanted I become with it, whether it's in the professional circuit. I'm realizing that I'm talking to mommy bloggers that have no idea what's going on in the world. And on the non-professional circuit, I'm dealing with people that use black hat tactics and don't even know that they're doing it. So
if you had a time machine and you could go back and talk to your younger self, you know, without causing any paradoxes or cataclysms to the space-time continuum. Thanks, by the way, for introducing me to Doctor Who. He's awesome. What are the top three things you would tell yourself to help prepare for your career?
You know nothing about the doctor. But, okay, the top three things that I would tell myself to prepare for my career are as follows. God, this question. Number one, talk to people. And not in a salesy way. Actually build relationships with people. Go to the local events. Whether it's meetups or actual digital summits. I live in Atlanta. There's no reason why I should not have gone to some of the events that I didn't go to. A lot of them aren't as expensive as like South by Southwest or something like that. They're a couple $100. Number three, be more of a consultant. Add more value without being the last rung on the totem pole. And if I had a time machine, I would know what that was because I see your face. I would know what that was because I'm talking to me.
So expound on that a little bit more. What do you mean by not being the last rung on the totem pole?
So I have a habit that was pointed out by somebody who I'm not going to mention any names, but I have a habit of severely over delivering beyond my position without any retribution.
So you just give and give and give with the expectation that, you know, it'll eventually come back, but they seem to just take it and run. Is that what you're saying?
A lot of times there is no expectation. I don't do things because I have an expectation that anything will transpire from it. I do it because I truly want to help. And that gets taken advantage of, especially when you're talking about Fortune 500 and Fortune 100 companies that you consult with, and you go above and beyond, and then you're just a number in the system that does numbers. I don't know what that thing is called, but you know what I'm saying.
Absolutely. Well, this has been great. We're going to take a short break, and then when we get back, we're going to drill down further with Michelle A. Bassett, so stick with me. In the last 3 months of the 2016 U.S. presidential election, fake news outperformed real news on Facebook. Now, don't worry, this is a podcast about marketing, not politics. But what I'm trying to pull out with that example is that most people can't call BS online when they see it. Now, this is in stark contrast to the whole un-college movement that favors finding information online, oftentimes for free, as opposed to paying for higher education. Now, that tactic can work, assuming you can call BS when you see it, which unfortunately, most people just can't. The ability to call BS online, what we call digital discernment, is a skill, which means that it can be learned. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course to learn the skill of digital discernment. In this short course, taught by yours truly, I condense my over a decade of trial and error experience, as well as the skill I learned getting a degree in digital marketing for your benefit. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course right now. That's bit.ly/D as in dog, M as in Mary, D as in dog course. And we're back. So, Michelle, you, Gary V, and Tim Ferriss, or insert whichever thought leader you happen to be around if you're at a different conference, you're all chilling at the bar after the conference having a straight talk, no BS, mini mastermind. What would you say is severely lacking from the professional digital marketing industry, and how would you brainstorm about correcting it?
Agile marketing with more testing. So it is not necessarily agile marketing per se, but that's the closest reference point I could get to that would people actually know what I'm talking about. But essentially, people, industries, agencies, whomever, need to really focus more on numbers that make sense for the bottom line and not just the bottom line. Major companies and agencies who follow suit have a tendency to do what everybody else does. And they run the same marketing campaigns, whether it's PPC, SEM, whatever. And it's like, if you truly care about delivering results, then look at the actual numbers. Split tests, variance tests, try something different. Don't be afraid to do something new or something that you don't think is going to work just because this company over here is not doing it or that guy down the hall is not doing it. Be different. Take chances. Get messy. Make mistakes. Miss Frizzle. Shout out to Miss Frizzle.
Absolutely. Because a thought leader that I follow, Jay Baer, he gets asked the question with some frequency, like, you know, how do you become a thought leader? And his answer is, have leading thoughts. So in other words, have a position, like take a stance, because if you're too busy being PC or, to your point, doing what everybody else is doing, you're really not talking to anyone. It's just noise. James Loomstein, who I had on episode 2, I believe, who's a professor at Southern Methodist University, he says it as, you know, it's better to be a meaningful specific than a wandering generality. So you have to be known for something. And if you're just, like you said, you know, talking everybody else's talk, then you're just, you know, another guy spouting the same noise. So, excellent. Mm-hmm.
Additionally, the leaders that we have today in not just in the internet marketing field or companies or corporations or whatever, but leaders need leadership skills. just because you are appointed to a position does not mean that you are the right pick. Like, the hand of God didn't come down and anoint you with all the wisdom that is necessary for you to have this position. So if you are a leader, or if you're trying to be a leader, or you call yourself a leader, you are a self-appointed leader of the world, then take time to really invest in truly becoming a leader. Take some leadership classes, some courses, and I have a personal rule that if you're the only one that is calling yourself a leader, then you may not be a leader. So if no one else is calling you a leader, you might want to rethink your position and try to actually lead. Not be a boss, because this whole boss meme is getting kind of out of control. So many people are trying to be bosses. But being a boss and being a leader are two very distinct things. So if you're trying to be a boss, rethink and pivot to being a leader. A boss leads, quote unquote, you can't see my air quotes, but leads, quote unquote, from a soapbox. They give orders and directions. A leader is much like when you see wolves run. You have the alphas typically, not necessarily in the front, but they're somewhere in the top 1 or 2%. They're out there getting dirty with you, because a lot of times this goes back to my previous statement. When you're a boss and you're just dictating out orders, you don't know what's going on in the streets per se. So if you have a CRM like Salesforce or something like that, and it goes down and you're just being a boss and no one tells you that it's down, you don't know it's down. Whereas if you're a leader and you're with your people and you're trying out the things and you're eating your own cooking, so to speak, then you know when Salesforce goes down. In fact, you probably know a couple seconds before everybody else do that Salesforce is down. So if you are a person where people come to you and say, hey, this isn't working, or hey, this is this way, or hey, this is that way, 9 times out of 10, you're a boss. If you can figure it out before your team figures it out, then you're a leader.
Absolutely. That's a very important distinction. So one last question, and I'll let you get back to your day. And I am going to take just a moment to set this up. And I know it's getting kind of redundant for my faithful listeners. However, every podcast is somebody's first podcast. So in my opinion, there is a gap in the professional digital marketing education space in terms of career trajectory. And when I say professional, I'm referring to somebody who works in-house at a corporation or brand or at an agency. I am not referring to digital entrepreneurship or solopreneurs, even though you could absolutely make the case that somebody like a Pat Flynn or John Lee Dumas are professionals because they operate at such a high level. That's not who I'm talking about. I'm talking about people with jobs, people who get a W-2 at the end of the year. So to our previous conversation, you start out by sort of meandering the wilds of Google for a year or 10. But there's absolutely no guarantees there. You might land on marketing profs, Udemy, or lynda.com. You might end up in a business that rhymes with Spamway. Like, there's just no guarantee. So after you're done kind of fooling around on Google, at some point you get serious. And at that point, you have two options. The first is you can do what we did, which is to go to college to get a degree in internet marketing. The problem with that is, even though the degree program is accelerated, it still takes 30 months to complete for the bachelor's and a year for the master's. And a lot can happen in between that time. Also, it's very expensive. I had to borrow the better part of $60,000 for my undergraduate. And so the alternative to that, and by far the more prevalent way of educating yourself and getting a hold of best in class practices, is through conferences and seminars. The problem with that is that your better conferences, like a South by Southwest or HubSpot Inbound, or you know, Marketing Profs B2B conference, these tend to range from about $500 to $1,500, and that's just to have your face in that place. That's just for the ticket. That doesn't include your flight, your hotel, Uber back and forth, food. After you add all that back in, you're looking at between $2,000 and $5,000 on a single weekend. And so even though in aggregate it's a lot less than going back to school, you have to have that money up front, and a lot of people just don't. So I'm trying to figure out, or crowdsource, if you will, an alternative to, you know, educating yourself at a professional level that does not include having to come up with, you know, a few thousand grand up front to go to a conference and get in a VIP training program or sell your firstborn to Sally Mae. So now that I'm done rambling, the actual question, which is, imagine you woke up in a brand new world, identical to Earth, but you knew no one. You still have all the experience, skill, and knowledge you currently have. Your food and shelter taken care of, but all you have is a laptop and no money. That's right, you are college freshman broke, baby. You got somewhere to lay your head, a meal plan, computer Wi-Fi, and that's it. How would you build relationships with industry thought leaders over the next 30 days by working for free?
Working for free. That hurts my feelings. But, okay. So, one, you got to go meet people because you don't know anybody. So, go meet people. Go to meetups.com. Not necessarily the Chamber of Congress because everybody's trying to like hustle their own services. But,
Chamber of Commerce.
I did not say that. Chamber of Commerce. Excuse me. So I would not go to that place, which is why I didn't pronounce it correctly. But also go hang out at like cool little jazzy spots. Like literally they're playing jazz because old people like jazz and old people have money. And 9 times out of 10, they figured out that they either have dealings in business or they know somebody that has a business. So one, I would go out and I would meet people. Also, old men like to give me food and drinks, even though I know that was already covered. But I got to stack the deck just in case stuff pops off again. So, I'm meeting new people, right? Next, I would provide value for those people. My initial value would be analysis type value, as far as let me look at your website, let me see what's going on, let me check out your funnel, because I am the funnel master. And then once I pointed out all of the things that weren't necessarily up to par, or I figured out where all the money was left on the table, then I would ask for some compensation to fix those issues. And I think that would be the whole thing right there. The whole gamut.
Absolutely. So, Michelle, this has been truly illuminating. Thank you so much for your time. Where can our listeners get some more of you? Do you have any books, websites, podcasts? Tell us how to get a hold of you.
I have a book. You keep mentioning it all the time. Beyond Buzzwords. which can be found on Amazon. That's always a good place to find books and whatnot. My blog is startmarketingwithmichelle.com with 2 L's. And from there, you can just either reach out to me on LinkedIn, which is Michelle with 2 L's, B in the number 6. And then for your special, special, special listeners, you can actually call me. I'm going to say it really fast before he cuts me off. Phone number 678-820-8258. I will give you a complimentary 10-minute conversation. He's looking at me. A complimentary 10-minute conversation. And we can just chat it up. Text me. And we can go from there. The number again is 678-820-8258.
You heard it there, folks. Don't sleep on this great deal because it will not last. So
it will not last. He's right. This offer expires on the Ides of March. March 15th.
Okay. Michelle, thank you so much for your time. I do appreciate it.
Thank you. Bye.
Have you ever been paralyzed while doing research? You go to Google, you type in your search query, and seconds later, you're hit with millions, if not billions, of search results, and you can't make heads or tails out of any of them. Overwhelmed and afraid you'll make the wrong choice, you don't make any choice at all. Well, friends, you're not alone, but you needn't suffer in silence. The ability to make sense out of what you find online, and more importantly, call BS when you see it, is a skill, which means that it can be learned. Go to bit.ly.com/DMD course right now to learn the skill of digital discernment. In this short course, taught by yours truly, I condense my over a decade of trial and error experience, as well as what I've learned getting a degree in internet marketing for your benefit. Go to bit.ly.com/D as in dog, M as in Mary, Ideas and Dog course. One more time, bit.ly.com/DMD course. Thank you for doing me the high honor of listening to the very end. Please subscribe in iTunes, Stitcher, or your favorite podcasting app. Leave a 5-star rating and write a review telling people about my unmitigated awesomeness. Really helps out with getting the show shown. Follow me on Twitter at Tembo8482. That's T-E-M-B as in boy, O-8482. Or connect on LinkedIn, and I'll have my LinkedIn description in the show notes. And I'll see you next week.